This is it, Jack. This is our day. This is your day. This is the day that we have been waiting for, and planning for, and praying over. This is our day. This is where love brings us. By the way, guys like me always say on a day like this, when such a thing happens, that traditionally rain on a wedding day is always good luck for a bride. Yeah. It's totally not true, but we're supposed to say that anyhow. Thank you all so much for being here with us today. This is where love brings us. This is where true love brings us. Not just what the world calls love, which is almost always some sort of self-centeredness. This is where selfless love brings us. Because real, true love is selfless. I don't know if there is any better description of what true love is than when the Apostle Paul wrote a letter to some of his friends in a city called Corinth, and he said, real true love is patient. It's kind. It's not envious or boastful or proud or rude or self-centered. Real love isn't easily angered. And it doesn't keep a record of wrongs. It doesn't delight in evil, but it always rejoices when the truth comes out. Real love always protects. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Real, true, genuine love never fails. And that's why we're here today. Of course, I'm not just talking about the love that David and Nancy have towards one another. Whenever they walk into a room, the whole place gets brighter. No, I'm also talking about the love that each and every one of you bring with you today. Look at you. You're out here sweating to death one minute, and you got your umbrella up the next. I'm talking about the love that each one of you bring. After all, it is all of you who have befriended them. It's all of you who have taught them. It's all of you who have raised them. It's all of you who have shown these two the benefits of pouring your life into someone else. So on behalf of David and Nancy, can I just say to you all, thank you. Thank you all so much for being here. Thank you for coming to celebrate with us today. In fact, if none of you would have shown up, we'd have really been embarrassed. But we would have eaten like kings, right? Thank you guys all so, so much for being here with us today. Let's do something a little bit different. Mom, come up and be with us for a second. Come on, come up and be with us. Thank you. Mom and Dad, come up and be with us for a second. Come on. Come on, come on. There she goes. Thank you, Mom. I want for you guys to get to where you can put your hands on the one you still own. You got a few more minutes left with that designation. Mom and Dad, come on up. Come on, come on. Come on, come be with us. There she goes. Yes, yes. There she goes. Excellent. Thank you. Thank you, Mom and Dad. Today is very much about David and Nancy. This is their day. But it's a little teeny bit about you guys as well. Because the most beautiful of memories are always the most painful. They're the most painful because whenever we recall them, we have to realize that they're already done. We can't go back. And all of our most beautiful memories have you two in them. We remember the first time we ever laid eyes on your tiny face. We remember the first time that you woke us up at 4 o'clock in the morning ready to party, Jack. We had to get up at 7 and you were like, let's go. We remember the first time that you put a few steps together and we were so excited. We said, look, they're walking. They're finally walking. And then for the next 16 years, we said, for the love of God, would you sit down and be still? We remember first few words. We remember those tiny kisses. We remember the first time that we drove you to kindergarten and we pretended to be all excited and then we cried the whole way home. And yet here they are. They're all grown up now. They are capable. They are mature, usually. They are independent. They are the best of us. Out of everything we have ever done wrong, you two are everything that we have ever done right. So, on behalf of the vows that David and Nancy are sharing towards one another on this day, can we all as one bigger family recommit ourselves to them one more time, that we will continue to give them all the hope, all the love, all the blessings and the protection of a bigger family, all the wisdom of our years, mom, dad, friends and family. So say we all, yes? And who today presents this woman to be married to this man?
Yes, my wife and dad.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Dad. Thank you, Mom and Dad. Hug it out. Here we go. Good job. Good job. Excellent.
No, it's okay.
There you go, baby. Very good. Now turn. Excellent work. You two are doing awesome. You know, from the very first time that we began to plan today, we all agreed on one thing, and that was today cannot be a ceremony. Ceremonies are boring. Ceremonies are cold and lifeless. Today, my friends, is not going to be a ceremony. Today is going to be a celebration, yes?
Yes.
Oh, they're not with us yet. I said today is not going to be a ceremony. Today is going to be a celebration, yes? Getting there. And my favorite part of any celebration is, of course, our call response blessing. All of you know what a call response blessing is. This is your opportunity to celebrate with us. This is your chance to call out over our bride and groom a word or two, a hope, a wish, a blessing, a prayer. And no matter what anybody says today, we all repeat it together because we're all family today. Call response. Now, I'm in charge, so I get to do the first one. And I wish for you both what everyone in the whole world wants more than anything else, what has started and ended wars, what makes music beautiful. I wish you both many, many years of true love. And we all repeat it together, true love. And now you got it, and it's your turn. Throw it over our bride and groom a blessing today. Twins? Are you serious? Right out of the gate, the first one. She said twins, and we all said?
Twins.
Somebody else?
No.
Wait, what was it?
Great health.
Oh my gosh, so young. You don't think about great health, but when you get to, yeah, great, I love it. She said great health, and we all wished?
Great health.
And I heard one from over here. What was it?
Happy.
Oh my gosh, so wise. Thank you. True happiness. I love it. Mom said happiness, and we all said
happiness.
Somebody else.
A lot of laughter.
Beautiful. So wise. The wise lady said a lot of laughter. I love it. And we wished.
Laughter.
I love it. Somebody else.
Warmth at night.
Wait. Hold. I had a wise one from over here. What was that?
Patience.
Here's the thing. Wrong person. Here's the thing with patience. You won't need it today, but trust me, that day will come. The wise woman said patience, and we all said?
Patience.
And from right here I heard?
Warmth at night.
There you go. You had it. Many, many warm nights together. He said warm nights, and we all wished?
Warm nights.
I love it. Who wants the last one?
Mutual respect.
Say it again, my friend.
Mutual respect.
So wise. I don't know if there can be one after that. That's beautiful. The wise gentleman said, mutual respect, and we all said,
mutual respect.
I love it, I love it. David and Nancy, you two are so, so blessed to be here today. And I don't mean here, as drop-dead gorgeous as here is. I mean what we are doing here today is very serious business. This is bigger than what some people call a love promise. You know how those work. The love runs out, the promise is shot. This is deeper than just a legal contract. Although I'm supposed to remind you both, guys, this is a legal contract, all right? Careful, careful. My friends, this is a vow. And let me strongly warn you about a vow. God's word says that if you take a vow with only two, it will never be full. God's word says in Ecclesiastes that a three-corded strand is not easily broken. Now we know with a three-corded strand who that represents. It represents mom, the wife, the beauty, the heart, the God-given wisdom and counsel of the wife has to make the home. God's word also says that the husband, that physical strength, sometimes that mind that works in a very different way, with the heart that says, I will protect and provide. God's word says you are essential to make this home. But he also says that in the same way that one of our founding fathers repeated, that unless a house labors with the Lord at the head, they labor in vain to create it. David and Nancy right now are weaving this three-chord strand together in symbolism with the understanding of God's word that a three-chord strand is not easily broken. It takes the husband, it takes the wife, and it takes our Almighty Father in accordance with his word to truly build a home. You're doing great. As the strand is wound together, symbolizing that we will always be together, united as a family under God's word.
Good job, guys. I'll let you do it. I'm just going to sit here and support.
Good job. You're being so supportive. Good word, David. Excellent. Good word, guys. Excellent. Good word, guys. Amen. You know, a vow is deeper than those other things that we talked about a minute ago. A true vow soberly taken as long as we both shall live. That means as long as breath remains in us, that vow remains with us. It's a commitment of honor. It's a commitment of integrity. It's a commitment of love. It's a commitment which cries out for better or for worse. Now let's stop at that one. Because for better or for worse says when there's a whole lot of month left and there ain't no money left, it's still for better or for worse. Says when I don't really see the future as clearly right now as what I did. When I don't know exactly where we're going, you're still my life's partner. For better or for worse. Says, and this is the hard one, guys, no matter how you treat me, I'm still going to love you selflessly for better or for worse. Says, I get to wake up with my best friend every single day. It's the never-ending sleepover. And I get to say to you first thing in the morning, hey, you know all those promises that I made to you since day one? I meant every single word. And I'm going to take today to prove it to you all over again for better or for worse. Celebrated French philosopher Simon Signoret once said, chains do not hold a marriage together. It's threads. It's thousands of tiny threads that we subconsciously sew together like weaving a cord. Day in and day out, year in and year out, until many, many decades in the future, we alone have the privilege of looking back on the beautiful tapestry that we have created, the history that is just ours. So, we bless you today, right? Yes, yes. All of us. That is why we are here, blessing you today. But it is up to you. I mean, from this day forward, it really, really is up to you to always selflessly regard one another to keep those blessings always moving forward. David, Nancy, do you both understand what I have charged you with so far? And are you ready to make your vows one towards the other at this time?
Yes.
Then, David, is it your truest desire at this time to choose Nancy as your wife to live together with her in marriage? And do you swear today before God, myself, and all of our gathered family and friends to love, to comfort, to honor, to keep, and to provide for her for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, remaining faithful to her only as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
You're up.
Sorry. Somewhere in here. Nancy, first off, you look beautiful today. I'm the luckiest man alive. Mm-hmm. You are the woman of my dreams, my soulmate. I'd waited what felt like a lifetime to find you. You're the most beautiful, caring, selfless, and talented person I know. You're everything that I'm not. I should have told you that every day since we've been together, and I will spend the rest of our lives making up for that. You've always been patient with me, understanding and supportive, and my best friend and biggest supporter. I can't promise you an easy life. I am a Powers, after all. But I can promise you that you will never be alone. We will walk together side by side and face what life throws at us. I promise to give you all of me every day, to be patient and understanding, to be comforting and supportive, loyal, faithful, and honest. I will never stop loving you, and I will always cherish you, no matter what lies ahead. Tienes todo mi corazón, mi vida, mi amor.
Nancy, is it your truest desire at this time to choose David as your husband to live together with him in marriage?
Oh, yes.
And do you swear today before God, myself, and all of our gathered family and friends to love, to comfort, to honor, to keep, and to provide for him for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, remaining faithful to him only as long as you both shall live?
I do. David, never in my wildest dreams I thought I'd meet the man I would marry at the gym. Since date one, we've been on the same page about what we want in life. I've never felt so comfortable, safe, and loved than when I am with you. I truly believe God placed you into my life at exactly the right time, when I was not ready, but needed your love the most. I am now more than ever a true believer that everything happens for a reason. The past 3.5 years, we've been on a crazy adventure. Traveled, experienced living in different states, and moving. Lots of moving. More than I have in my entire life. And we have grown together so much. With you, nothing has felt so right. I feel fortunate beyond words to go through this life with a man like you. A man that's truly genuine, kind, intelligent, funny, driven, and so charming as you. I love everything I've discovered in you, both the good, the bad, and the ugly. I genuinely love all of you. You showed me a life I never thought I'd be blessed enough to experience, and as we stand before our closest friends and familia, here are the promises I make to you. I vow to center us in gratitude with the Lord and to always choose him first over the priorities this crazy world has for us, and to pursue you best. I promise always to respect and pray for you. I pledge to always believe in you and help you see the incredible person that you are. I promise to always tell you through actions and words how much I truly adore you. I promise to always tell you through, promise to always be willing to change and to serve you better. I vow to have a heart that is always ready to ask for forgiveness and a heart that will always be willing to forgive. I promise to be strong when needed and sensitive when needed. And I promise to pray for wisdom to know the difference. I promise to always remain faithful and to choose you daily. I promise to have and to hold you from this day forward, for better or worse. I promise to love you for richer or poorer. I promise to love you in sickness and in health. And I promise to celebrate our seasons of health and weather the seasons of sickness. I promise to love you and cherish you till death do us part. Life will not always be easy, as you said, and we will not always have answers, but I promise to let the Lord be our guide. David, I choose you today, I'll choose you tomorrow, and I'll keep choosing you day after day. Forever I am yours, forever I do. Damel, must.
Rings are adornments. They are carefully chosen, sometimes for their extravagance, sometimes for their simplicity. They quietly sit on our finger as a constant reminder of our lover, of the vows that we have made to one another to be faithful, to be true, to nourish our love so that it always lasts for a lifetime. Traditionally, they are often David, brother, on a side note, between me and you and nobody else in the room, guys that look like me and you put a ring on a woman who looks like that so that whenever we take her out in public and show her off to everybody, that ring says what?
She's mine.
She's mine. Very simple. That's exactly right. She's mine. She's a taken woman. And that ring on his finger says what?
He's mine.
That's right. And in the same way that we put our signature on a written contract or a covenant which says, this is my word and my vow. In the same way, on this day do we exchange these rings to seal the vows of our marriage. My friends, there may be many rings floating around out there that look like these, but none are these. These are your rings. These are the symbols of that first day that you ever laid eyes on each other. Remember?
Oh, yes.
Until many, many decades in the future from now, may these rings forevermore be the most treasured adornment that you ever wear, but may all that they symbolize be the most precious commodity that you ever own. David, taking Nancy's ring, placing on the ring finger of her left hand, and as you do so, repeating after me, with this ring.
With this ring. Oops, sorry, time out. With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I pledge to you today.
I pledge to you today.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
My life.
My life.
My love.
My love.
And my sacred honor.
And my sacred honor.
Nancy taking David's ring, placing on the ring finger of his left hand, and as you do so, repeating after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I pledge to you today.
I pledge to you today.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
My life.
My life.
My love.
My love.
And my sacred honor.
And my sacred honor.
My friends, I'm going to pray over our brand new family starting today. If you will, in a symbol of unity, reach your hands out over our couple right now as I pray with them. Almighty Father, Lord, we lift you up because you are good, because your mercy endures forever, because you want good things for us, no matter what package they come in. Father, we bring before you our brand new family today, David and Nancy, asking you not only that you would bless them, but that you would greatly favor them, that you would cause everyone around them to be blessed because you are favoring them. Father, that if it is your will and plan that children become part of their family, that you would cause them to grow up and be raised up as men and women of God who care about honoring you and who honor their mother and father. Father, we pray today that you would keep them safe, keep them healthy in this time, keep them free from sin throughout time, And may today be a day of many beautiful starting memories. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Well, since everybody out here is freezing to death, let me just go ahead and make this whole thing official, official, official. But one more thing I want you to do. Because almost all weddings have a few things in common, one of which is that there's almost always some type of big distraction during the ceremony. A baby falls over, a plane flies overhead, a few seconds of rain to cool everything off. We've been wonderfully blessed with those things so far. Another thing is that usually about 6 weeks out, one of you looks at the other and goes, oh my gosh, we forgot about this. And then about 6 days out, the other one goes, oh my gosh, and we didn't plan for that. And sometimes by the morning of, one of you just looks at each other and goes, Vegas, we should have just gone to Vegas like we talked about. And that can lead to stress. And nobody wants stress for you today. So I want for you to forget about 3 weeks and 3 days and 6 hours ago, and I want for you to concentrate on just now. Because you see, I told your mom and dad a little while ago that the most beautiful memories are often the most painful. And the thing is, as I talked about you guys being little children, to them it seems like just yesterday. And then a few weeks from now, you two guys are going to look back on this day and you're going to say, you know, it went by way, way too fast. So I want for you to forget about everything but this moment.
As a matter of fact, guys, if you could, I would encourage you to forget about everybody else here. Oh, I know, that's almost impossible. You got a lot of people here who love you dearly, and you love them dearly, la familia. But from this day forward, all of those people will be very prominent in your life. But the person who is to be preeminent is holding your hand right now. No one must come between the two of you. There's going to be a lot of people who well-meaningly say things like, oh, once kids come along, you're not going to be able to concentrate on each other anymore, so you better enjoy it. Don't believe that crap. I'm not kidding. Don't believe that. Your children will learn how to love each other and others by how you two love. They'll learn how to put you two first by how you two put each other first. So let me encourage you to put God and His Word first in your family. After that, each other. And if you continue to do that for the next 25 years, you're going to continue to make everybody as jealous as you are right now. And because I'm still in charge, for 3 more minutes, I get to be the first person to say congratulations to you both. You are my new favorite couple. I believe in you guys.
One last thing. I want you to just look at each other right in the face. There you go. Today's been hectic and busy. Now, if this gets awkward, I don't want you to look away because you're going to be looking at this face for a long, long time. I want you to memorize every curve, every line, and those strong eyes, and that gorgeous smile. And I want you to lock this vision away in your heart of hearts. Because, David, let's be honest with you, brother, 25 years from now, Jack, you ain't gonna look the way you do today, buddy. Nancy will. Guys, don't ever forget this day, this moment, this time. You'll need it, and you'll have it. You know, my favorite author outside of Scripture is a guy by the name of Ted Geisel. You may not recognize the name Ted Geisel, but you'll definitely know his pen name, Dr. Seuss. Dr. Seuss said something one time that I've never forgotten. He said, you finally know when you're really in love, when just maybe for the first time in your life, you just can't seem to fall asleep anymore because your new reality is so much better than your best of dreams ever were. David, Nancy. Your new reality, your very best of dreams, starts right now. By the authority granted me by the great Commonwealth of Virginia, I very, very proudly pronounce you both as husband and wife, David. You lucky dog, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great honor and privilege to be able to present to you for the very first time in public, Mr. and Mrs. David and Nancy Powers.
On the rocks, you're sipping juice. My fingers tracing the outlines of your heart tattoo. No one to tell us what to do. Oh, I'm ready for love for you. I'm staring at your silhouette. I watch the golden lights around you as the sun begins to set. Still got one crazy night ahead. You know I'm ready. I know we ain't no angels, I know we ain't no gods, but heaven's shining down on us. Ain't no better day for love. Ain't no better day for love. Ain't no better day for love. No pretending we're asleep. Our body language says it all, no, we don't need to sleep. Just tell me underneath the sheet. Oh, I'm ready for you, for me. I know we ain't no angels, I know we ain't no gods, and I know that we ain't perfect. I know we ain't no angels, I know we ain't no gods. Heaven's shining.